Today's topic will be on pulpal necrosis. So necrosis means death. So death of the pulp is called pulpal necrosis. So why the pulp necrosis occurs is that if you have a caries or an attrition or abrasion which may ultimately lead to pulpitis, that to an irreversible pulpitis, if it's getting untreated, then it will lead to necrosis, or it may be a traumatic injury, it may lead to necrosis. So any type of event which leads to interruption of the blood supply will ultimately lead to pulp necrosis. So these are the causes. And if it is, what are the types? For example, in multiple canal tooth, one canal will be vital and few canals will be necrosed. In that, it's called partial. If all the canals are necrosed, then it's called total. So clinically, they will be asymptomatic. If it is, for example, even if you do an electric pulp testing in this case, it will not respond because it's all the canals are become necrosed. So unless and until it's getting involved with the PDL, it will be asymptomatic. Okay, unless and until it involves the PDL, it will be asymptomatic. Mostly it will not be there, because as soon as the pulpal necrosis occurs, it automatically goes to the PDL involvement and the patient arises pain. So there will be no response in case of total necrosis of the pulp. And what happens, what is happening is that the bacteria and the toxins in the pulp chamber is causing the tissue, that is the protein degradation, the protein breakdown is occurring. And the PDL, if it goes beyond the PDL, then the widening of space and tendon perfusion and pain on chewing, everything is a consequence. Okay. So microscopically, you will see a necrosed area. It's called liquefaction necrosis due to cellular degeneration of the tissue and insufficient drainage due to the closed chamber of the canal, which is bounded with a dentin. It has an insufficient space for the drainage of inflammatory exudate. So it will be a tissue pressure rises so that the necrosis occurs. So these necrotic particles or the inflammatory exudate invade the dentinal tubules. That is the reason when we do a root canal treatment, we do a biomechanical preparation. That is, we are going to remove the dentinal tubules which is infected with the necrosed tissue. Okay. So visually, you may see a discoloration in an anterior teeth like gray or pinkish blue. Okay. So this is the overall view of pulpal necrosis. Thank you.